Is there?
No, just the
Okay.
English. So we are in the article called Mutual Responsibility, Arvut. We are on verse 28. Can you please read out loud?
Yes. Now we fully understand the previous words, for he says, "Now, if you surely listen to my voice and keep my covenant," meaning make a covenant on what I am telling you here, "to be my segula from among all peoples." This means that you will be my segula, and sparks of purification and cleansing of the body will pass through you unto all the peoples and the nations of the world. For the nations of the world are not yet ready for this. And at any rate, I need one nation to start with now, so it will be as a remedy for all the nations. For this reason, he ends, "For all the earth is mine," meaning all the peoples of the earth belong to me, as do you, and are destined to adhere to me, as written in item 20. But now, while they are still incapable of performing
Let's
that
pause for a
task,
second.
okay?
So he's telling us here, Rabbi Ashlag, that God, if you look carefully on the Bible, when on the story of Mount Sinai, God is telling the people of Israel, if you listen to my voice and keep my covenant. So Rabbi Ashlag says, what do you mean listen to your voice? What exactly did you say that? Tell us what is it that we need to listen to? And what exactly is the covenant? Means it's not clear. And then you'll be a virtue. Also, it's not clear. What does it mean that I'll be a virtue? Okay. And Rabbi Ashlag explained, what does it mean to be a virtue? It means that if the people will do the effort to work deeply inside to clean their ego. And transform their desire to receive that it will be purely for the sake of sharing, then you'll be like a channel to help all the rest of the world to also start to do their spiritual cleansing. And that's why, in the beginning of the book, if you remember, Rabbi Ashlag asked, why didn't God ask all the people of the world to come to Mount Sinai and to receive the Torah? Why did God only give it to people of Israel? And Rabbi Ashlag mentioned that it says in the ancient writings that God did offer it to the nations of the world, but they refused. The idea is that God wanted to give the Torah to all the people of the world because the Torah is the teaching, the energy that helps a person to transform the desire to receive for the self alone for the sake of sharing so a person can become a pure channel of light, and as a result, become cleaved to the Creator. So God wants all humanity to achieve that level. But back then, on the time of Mount Sinai, 3,300 years ago, most of the world was not ready. So God told the people of Israel, "You're gonna be a virtue. You're gonna work very hard on yourself spiritually, and from the sparks of light that you will reveal." It will give strength to all the people of the world eventually also to do their spiritual journey, right? You
Yes.
can, yeah, okay. And
Yes.
then God says, what does it mean? And because I own the land, because he says, and you know, it says, I own the land means all the people of the world belong to me. And eventually, all humanity, all the people of the world will be cleaved to me. But back then, as we said, people of the world were not ready for this spiritual work. That's why God asked the people of Israel to take upon themselves. And that's the idea of chosen people. Sometimes people think chosen people means God said, you are more special for me than other nations of the world. And Rabbi Ashlag says, no, don't think like that. Rabbi Ashlag says, God chose them just to be channels to bring this message to all humanity, but not chose them as like their favorite nation. Okay. And the
Yes.
idea is, and you'll be a Kingdom of priest. What does mean kingdom of priest? The same way that a priest, his job in the time of the temple was to bless the people of Israel in order to help all the people of Israel to go through their spiritual cleansing and to get closer and closer to God. Also, God says to the people of Israel, your work is to be like a kingdom of priest, to give blessing to all humanity, that every human being in the world will have the strength to do their spiritual work. And what does it mean to be a kingdom of priest? I want you to read just a little bit more from where you stopped, okay?
Okay, do you want me to start with but now?
Okay.
Okay, but now while they are still incapable of
Just a
performing.
second. You finished what before what we before? Yes, you finished. But now, yes.
Okay.
Go ahead. Yes, sorry.
But now while they are still incapable of performing that task, I need a virtuous people. If you agree to be the remedy for all the nations, I command you to be unto me a kingdom of priests, which is the love of others in its final form of love your friend as yourself, the axis of all the Torah and mitzvot. And a holy nation is the reward in its final form of devkut with him,
Bikut
which
means
includes
cleaving in Hebrew.
cleaving, yes. With
Yes.
him, which includes all the rewards that can even be conceived. These are the words of our sages in clarifying the ending. These are the words which you will say to the children of Israel. They made the precision. These are the words, no more and no less. This is perplexing. How can you say that Moses would add or take away from the words of the Creator to the point that the Creator had to warn him about it? We find no such example in the whole of the Torah. On the contrary, the Torah says about him, for he is the trusted one in all my house.
So he says that that's the idea of kingdom of a priest, to get to a level that you fully apply the idea of loving the fellow man as yourself. And that's the, as we know, that's the entire message of the Torah. God says, start to live in that consciousness, that all your consciousness all day long is caring and sharing for each other. And by doing that, you'll be a kingdom of a priest. You will become channels of love to all humanity, basically. Okay? And
Yes.
then you'll be a holy nation. What does it mean you'll be a holy nation? God says in the Bible to the people of Israel on Mount Sinai. It means holy nation. It means you'll have the merit to cleave to me. It means the reward of your effort. And that's the message for us. When I'm making the effort to care and to love the other human being unconditionally, my reward is that I earn the idea of cleaving to God. That's the ultimate reward. That's the ultimate pleasure that a person can, can imagine or even not imagine, you know? So that's the reward of making the effort of pushing ourselves to love and to care and to actually help all humanity to also get closer and closer to the Creator. And just to finish what it says, God says to Moses, those are the things that I want you to tell the people of Israel. And Rabbi Ashlag says, why God need to tell Moses, those are the things? Means it's like God says, please be exact about what I'm telling you. Don't say more than what I told you. Don't say less. Rabbi Ashlag asks, can it be that God think that Moses can actually change from the words of God, say more or say less? God, Moses is the most loyal person to God, right? So that's kind of a question that next time, Be'ezrat Hashem, we'll continue to study, he'll answer
Yes,
it. Okay?
that sounds great.
Yeah,
Yes,
so
thank
hold
you.
on. So we'll remember that we